Hey there, Caitlin here, Snap-in Nutrition Educator in Waldo County, Maine. Today we're going to do some summer spritzers. I've got six quick and easy but beautiful drink recipes for you to put together. If you're bored of just seltzer water or ice water or the classic lemonade, this is definitely a way to spice up your summer drink repertoire. So we're going to start with some blueberry tea, and I have some ice cubes that I froze with some lemon and blueberry. I'm going to squeeze some lemon in there, top it with the tea, and then go ahead and top it with some seltzer water. And there you have it, one recipe down. For the next one, we're going to take some grapefruit, squeeze some juice in there, add a couple slices, and then add a sprig of rosemary. This is one of my favorite combinations. I know it sounds a little bizarre, but definitely give it a try, especially if you're a grapefruit fan. So I'm just going to muddle that into the glass. I'm actually just using the butt end of a spoon, a wooden spoon. Use whatever you have. You don't need to buy any special tools for this or anything. And then I'm going to go ahead and just add some plain ice. Please feel free to get more creative with your ice than I did and send me a picture. Then I just put a giant slice of grapefruit on the edge of the glass and filled the whole thing with seltzer water. I love it as is, but if you wanted it a little sweet, you could add a couple drops of stevia or a little squirt of agave, whatever you prefer. But there we have it, another drink recipe done. So then for this one of my favorites, we're gonna take some watermelon. I love watermelon, so I'm definitely not skimping on it here. I'm gonna go ahead and muddle it. I did rinse the spoon so that we're not cross-contaminating or blending flavors too much. And then I'm gonna add some more fancy ice. This time I made, nope, not ice yet. So I made this syrup with mint and a little bit of brown sugar. It was about a whole pint of water and a third of a cup of brown sugar. And then just kept that in the fridge, and I add it to bubbly water whenever I want something sweet. Then I tore up some mint leaves to release all of those yummy oils. And I have some ice cubes, finally the ice cubes. Some just have mint and some actually have melon and mint. You can just freeze watermelon cubes and they work great as little ice cubes. They kind of disintegrate as they melt, but just have fun with it. Then I topped the whole thing with seltzer water and there you have it, so yummy. Then for the next recipe, I'm actually gonna give this one to my little guy, so I made it in a plastic cup. But I'm gonna take a bunch of pitted cherries, and cherries are super fresh right now, so it's definitely a great time for this drink. And I'm gonna muddle them up a little bit in the bottom of the glass, then add some ice, and actually use the ice to help me muddle up the cherries. The ice will push down and release more of those juices than I could get with just the spoon. Then I'm gonna squeeze half of a lime in there. I love this combo, cherry and lime. Definitely one of my favorites. Then I'm gonna slide a couple lime wedges in there. My little guy likes to take them out and lick them and be real brave and try the sour. So I'll add those and then top it with some bubbly water. There you have it. I didn't add any sweetener. Sometimes I do it without the bubbly water because my little guy isn't always in the mood for the bubbles. But then I just take a straw and mix it all up, and all that yummy cherry juice and the lime juice from the bottom just mixes right in. It's really yummy. Then for our next recipe, I made these ice cubes with a little lemon slice and some slices of strawberry. If you've ever been to Starbucks and gotten the pink tea or the passion tea, you can actually buy the box. The brand is called Tazo, T-A-Z-O, and you can buy the passion tea mix or the passion tea bags and make it yourself and save a bunch. So I took some of that passion tea and some seltzer water, and there you have it, another lovely little mocktail. Then this one's really fun. My husband's from Thailand and this butterfly pea tea is really popular there. When you originally steep it, it's actually pretty blue, a little bit purple, but mostly blue. And then when you add citrus to it, it turns it pink. So the more citrus you add, the closer to pink it gets. You can see as I'm squeezing the little limes in there, it's starting to get a little purple. And then I'm gonna go ahead and take some bottled lime juice and just squirt it in there and watch the colors change. I love it. I just think that's so cool. You can totally freeze the tea ahead of time. The ice will sort of help to keep the citrus and the tea separate. I also added some agave for sweetness. And there you have it. Six simple and beautiful mocktail recipes. Don't forget to be creative, make it your own. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe out there. Wash your hands. Have fun with it. Please subscribe. It really does help us out. And head to mainsnackpad.org for more. Also, if you'd like to receive texts to help you shop, cook, and eat healthy on a budget, check out the link in the description box below.